Hey guys, welcome back. Probably been wondering where I've been. So I've still been training, but I had to take a little bit of a step back. It's a bit of a long story, so I won't go into it too much, but basically about 2 weeks ago now I tweaked my lower back. And I was a little bit touch and go of whether or not I should be still training or doing what I'm aiming for, which is basically my first ever powerlifting competition. The good news is that I'm still going to be competing. It just meant that I had to take a step back. So I had basically the morning that the injury happened, it was the day that I had to pull 117.5 kilos, which for me, I know it's not the heaviest deadlift in the world, but for me, that was a new PB. And I'm happy to say that the 117.5 came up fairly easily. Everything was fine. The lift felt good. Come off the floor nice and quick. It was fine.
There we go. 117 and a half. Forget this. This is the heaviest I've ever lifted on a deadlift. So.
It was fine. That was my heavy single for the day. And then I had three heavy singles at 105 kilos to do. So I should preface this with saying I done everything I was supposed to do. I went in, I warmed up, I loosened up. Done my stretching beforehand, done some quick exercises, went into squats felt fine, went into my deadlifts, built up to the 117.5, felt fine, and then when I dropped to 105, on the first lift of my 105 for three, I don't know what happened, the bar came off the ground, everything was fine, basically cleared the bar past my knees. And you'll see in the video, I just felt a little pop. It was in my lower back. You can actually see in the video, there's just a little bit of a stutter. And then I continue throughout the lift. That kind of initial pause is quite literally my lower back popping. I'd never experienced anything like that before. So I got free.
Yeah, so we hit the 117, three singles now at 105 kg.
Lift, put the bar back down and immediately stopped training. I left the gym. I actually called my wife because my back was a little bit sore at the time. I live about a 15-20 minute walk from the gym where I'm training now. So my wife came down and collected me and I went home. I took 2 days off work. long story short, talking to my coach Laura, she advised me on how to look after my back, between hot and cold. She changed my plan. I basically stopped training for the guts of a week. She then changed my plan in that for a few days, I wasn't to do anything kind of too heavy. It was all maintenance. It was supposed to be a deadlift session. But I ended up benching while everybody else deadlift. And I actually got an 82.5 kilo bench press that day. This was about a week after not training. And the 82.5 kilo bench press was again another personal best. So that's the most I've lifted as well. My back kind of, after a week, you know, we could basically say, oh no, that was fine. I don't know what it was. Everything feels good now. So I'm back to training properly. But it was that thing of, we needed to take that step back in training to give my back some time. Luckily, it looked like it was just muscular and it wasn't anything too serious. It was more that I just got a fright. And like that, if you feel it and it's like, oh shit, maybe it's best to take a step back, especially when it comes to your back. You don't want to aggravate anything, slip a disc, make it worse. So yeah, I just took a step back from training. I'm back now. I've been kind of training the last week or so, but not much. I only trained 2 days last week. So then this week now I'm back to my regular schedule of training 4 days this week. With a potential fifth day of just kind of just taking over, but we'll see how we feel. It's so close to competition now. Today is the 4th of December, so my competition's on the 16th, so we're not too far out. This week is going to be a little bit heavier, and then I think the week of competition, I'm not really going to be training much. I also went to a hot and cold plunge for the first time. I couldn't get footage of that. Just those other people there, you have to be respectful of people. But it's a place called Hot Box Sauna. It's quite literally a sauna next to the Boyne River in the Boyne Valley in Mead. And the night that I decided to go was the coldest night this winter so far. It's actually gotten colder since then, but that was last Thursday. It's Monday now, and we'll definitely be doing that again. Felt really, really good after. You feel charged, and also it's good for inflammation. So my back feels strong. So today it's Monday, so it's legs. But when I go in, my main movement for the day is my pause deadlift. So that's at 90 kilos. So it's 5 sets by 2 reps. So I'll build up slowly to 90 kilos, maybe just doing a couple of traditional deadlifts just to kind of warm everything up. And then I'll go into the pause deadlifts, but it won't be anything too heavy. So into 90 kilos, my pause deadlifts. And then it's basically on to more or less a normal leg routine. And then I think at the end, I have a small bit of bench. And then that'd be legs. So it's not as intense as it usually is. Because like that, with competition being so close, it's about preserving the body. So everything, the training is still there. The weights are still there. But that intensity is just dialed back just a little bit. Training today, which is Monday, tomorrow morning, day off. So that brings us to Wednesday, and then back in Thursday, and then back in on Saturday and potentially Sunday. So yeah, should be fine, should be all good. It's, as I said, it's early enough now, so what time are we? It's 5:20 in the morning, so the gym opens at 5:30, so by the time I get down there, the gym will be open, so I will get the rest of my monster into me. I know it's early, but it's going to help me through the workout, and I will leave, and I'll see you guys in the gym.
Yeah. First kind of warm up set, 70 kilos. That felt okay. Yeah, so we're up to 80 kilos. Just gonna do 5 quick reps just before I jump into my pauses at 90. You feel okay. Back feels good. First to 5 sets of pause deadlift. 90 kilos. Number 2. Set number 3. Set 4. Yeah. floor press. Firstly, mostly leg day, but the way the gym is laid out, it's hard to record for legs, so I just kind of took a few videos, but the deadlifts is mainly that, and then the floor press. So this is working my way up to a max set of 5, and then back off and do another 2 sets, I think. So I'm going to work my way up to the maximum set of 5 reps. Starting off right now at 40 kilos. That felt pretty good, fairly easy at this stage. Now, set number 2, up to 50 kilos. Fairly easy, so up we go. Obviously, I'll floor press a bit harder on the wrist, so probably 60 kilos for 5, so let's see how this goes. Still definitely some more in the tank there. Yeah, so up to 70 kilos. Again, let's see how this goes. Yeah. Oh yeah, right. So, to me, that's as close to max as I'm going to get with that. That last one was a grind. So, we'll back off. What? 65? Do 3 more sets. See how that goes. Now, 3 more sets and then we're done. Backed off to 65 kilos, see how this feels. If I need to come down more, we will. Happy because floor press is difficult, and I'm fairly sure I'm pressing heavier in terms of the amount of volume I've done. I'm still finishing stronger than I did the last time I did this. So, then home, shower, protein shake and coffee. Finish. Now, there we go, workout done, I'm back home. It's now 8:10 in the morning. Home, have a shower, get ready for work,
a few thoughts on today's session. So today was, it's kind of a medium day. It wasn't too heavy. I need to stop touching my face in videos. Yeah, so it was a medium day. I think the deadlifts went okay. Felt good on the pause. Back felt fine. Felt like they moved fairly quickly off the floor. It's going to be interesting to see what I'm going to pull on the day, because Laura has basically said to me, with kind of my back, she's worried about putting too much strain on it right now. So she wants to kind of just play it by ear and be careful and kind of give everything on the day. We're very, very close to the comp now anyway. So it's not ideal, but the way things have worked out, I would have been kind of backing off anyhow. It's fine. I don't have any pain, so that's a good thing. Deadlifts went fine. Unfortunately, I couldn't get a lot of footage in the gym today. Leg day is kind of awkward just because of where equipment is placed and so on and so forth. It's hard to set up the gimbal and the tripod without it being in someone's way, or potentially getting other people doing exercise, doing their routines. So I just kind of have to be a bit careful with that. What else? The floor press. I started out at 40 kilos and worked my way up to 70, I think. Yeah. Floor press for me anyway, it's one of those, it feels a bit awkward to do. The bar, trying to get the bar down to your chest, obviously your arms touch the floor first. So it's one of those things of, you have to kind of, the whole idea is to pause at the bottom anyway to power through. So it's almost like a board press in a way, in terms of the range of motion. But yeah, I worked my way up to 70 kilos for 5 reps, which again on floor press is I'm very happy with that, because realistically there's no leg drive on that. It's literally all upper. 70 kilos for 5 reps is quite good, and then I backed off I think to 65, and then backed off for the last 2 sets to 60. Everything felt really, really good. So it was a good productive session today. Tomorrow I think is predominantly a big bench day, so I have to go for a heavy single tomorrow, I think. Outside of that's pretty much the day. I'm gonna get myself ready, fueled, caffeined up, more caffeine for work basically. Work is absolutely mental at the minute, so it's just hard to keep the motivation, keep taking over between work, training, family life, everything else. But this is it. This is life. It's part of being an adult, unfortunately, part of being a husband and a father. You just keep taking over. If you stop and give yourself excuses, you just fumble and fall, in my experience. So it's best to just keep the momentum going. Listen, appreciate any likes, subscriptions, comments, whatever. Again, it's more vlog style. So it's more, I did this to potentially meet people online, have a chat, just have a little community around powerbuilding. Powerlifting. But that's the day anyway. Appreciate it. Thank you.